would have eaten. And God planted something. Okay, I need y'all to stay focused now. Stay tracking. Did you find out three? I see you still looking. Anybody find out three? All right, y'all find the next week. No, it's three more. Y'all found two. Yeah, that was enjoyment, and wasn't one of them. But I mean, that's, you can relate that to the other ones. The life of spot, it is enjoyment and resort of paradise. So the Lord God planted a garden east. What was it do? East of?
Eastward
in Eden. From where we at now, where I'm standing, the way you said, where is east? Where's east? I know I'm seeing some of y'all direction. Where's east? Where's east at? Not where east at. Wait, where east at, pal? East is that way?
That's the way the sun rises.
The rise, the sun rise well. Thank you. And it sets well. Okay, so where is that? Now see, some of y'all just got to quit. Y'all got to quit. Alright. We use that illustration, we use that example, so you can kind of picture God planted. The Lord God planted a garden eastward. It said eastward. The Lord God planted. Now y'all catch this now. He planted the garden. He planted it. Why did he plant it? Because he had a specific purpose is good. That plan is good. He had a specific purpose for that garden he planted eastward in Eden. He planted that garden eastward in Eden because he understood what Eden meant. A delightful spot. An open door. I ain't gonna give y'all out of three. I know y'all waiting on me. Yeah. Say it again? No, sir.
Because if you take the analogy and say a garden versus a field.
Yes, sir.
A garden means intimacy.
Yes, sir.
That's something that you can feel with.
Okay.
A field is something bigger that's gonna take a lot of focus.
Moment!
Moment! Yes, sir. Moment. He got it. Moment. And it's two more. Y'all working on the Holy Ghost bringing it back to you. Yeah, but what Pastor Thornton said, yes, sir. Yes, sir. All that is right on course. Alright? So the Lord God planted a garden. Now he planted it now. He planted it. Why? Because now think now. He had a specific purpose for that garden he planted eastward in Eden. Come on, y'all. Okay, huh? Presence. Good God. Deep boy. Deep boy about that now. Deep pull him now, boy. Deep pull him. I can tell you now. I got more.
Somebody ask the other one.
Yes, sir. Open door. For what? Huh? His presence. For open. For a delightful place. Delightful. What up, delightful? So go back up and see why the rivers was the water of what? Okay, all right. All right, let me show now. Okay, all right. All right, keep on reading now, dude.
And the Lord God took the man and put him into the garden of Eden and to dress it.
Uh-oh, hold on. And the Lord God now takes man and put him into the garden to influence it.
Got it.
He renewed.
And the Lord God commanded the man, saying, of every tree of the garden,
see, listen now.
Thou mayest freely eat. For the tree of knowledge of good and evil, thou shalt not eat of it. For in the day thou eatest thereof, thou shalt surely die.
Okay, all right now, y'all. You see, y'all got the instruction? Yes. Y'all see what God told him? Dude, go back up and read that verse again. Read it slow.
But of the tree of knowledge of good and evil, thou shalt not eat of it. For in the day that thou eat of thereof, thou shalt surely die.
Somebody talk about that. You see him talking to influence now. Now, God has given him instruction.
Yeah.
He said now. He's telling the man now, hey, hold on now. He ain't called him Adam yet, but he is Adam. He said, look now, put you here. I'm telling you the parameters. I'm giving you the boundaries. You have within you everything you need to influence this God, to cause it to be colonized like heaven. I've given you all the things that you need to cause this to take place. See, all right now. See, y'all have a hard time understanding this because you don't know how heaven operates. But God has set the parameters for you. God Almighty. Oh boy. Anybody have any questions or comments? Go ahead, because I know some. I just see it. Come on. Y'all got them? Y'all have them? Come on. Y'all can ask them. Yes, sir.
That's the one I'm
getting. Yes, sir.
With
an
age
bar. Yes, sir. Anybody want to say anything about Adam's name? Pastor, you got anything about Adam's name? Now somebody, huh?
They read that?
Yeah.
Because he's falling from the right.
Uh oh. Uh oh.
This function is like God. This God already breathed in the spirit.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Now he's getting ready to place his influence on the animals. That God will call something. Uh-oh. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay? And so now, whatever Adam called him, that's what they were. All right. Now, let me see if y'all catch it. How would Adam know what to call them if he had never seen them before? Y'all tracking now. So who's the one influencing Adam? All right. Who's the one supposed to be influencing us in the earth now? Thank you. So why is it so many people say that they are led by the Spirit, being influenced by the Spirit, but the stuff that they do, it don't add up to the Spirit of God?
Amen.
Oh, heavens. And so they'll put up a big fight because they think that they're right because this is how we done it, or this is where it's supposed to be done because this is all we know. Really? What about going back and allowing the one that knows everything, the Spirit of truth, Spirit of wisdom, come on now, allow him to govern. Oh, no doubt. He gave him a delegated authority. And so whatever Adam called him, that's what they were called. All right? So what happened? Okay? All right? Gave him a deal. Adam, what said that deal you had? Say it correctly. Why? Because Adam had God in him. And God just confirmed that what you said was correct. See, be careful. When it seems like everybody else is going south and you still going north, and because they're going south, they claim you're wrong because they got more going south than going north. I had a dream. I'm telling you what. Y'all didn't understand what I be going through sometimes. It's just demonic, Deacon Smith. It's just spiritual warfare. See, he's dumb.
Yes.
I know he's stupid. Because see, he think he can get you when your body is resting, but he failed to realize that you're still spirit.
That's right.
And spirit you never sleep.
That's right. That's
so when he can't get you while you're awake,
that's right.
He trying to get you while your body is resting.
Yes.
Shut up. And so he's stupid.
Yeah.
Because if you understand and stay in right relationship with the Lord, the angels got you. They're holding while your body is resting.
Yeah.
He still is stupid to try to get you, because that's when you are more powerful. Y'all ain't hearing. But some of y'all think y'all are more vulnerable when you sleep than you are when you awake. Good God from Zion. And so that you'll love to come, Pastor White, while you sleep. And I tell you, a lot of things the Lord showed me gotcha. And so he know he can't get you to sin because you're too mature to fall for them tricks now. But he try to keep us occupied doing a bunch of good things, but not the right thing. Y'all ain't hearing me. I got shot. And so Eve, if I can get you to do a good thing, to eat from the tree of knowledge of good and evil, I can coerce y'all into being separated from God. Because they look good. Y'all miss it. Y'all miss it. It said the tree was, it looked good. And so when we really start doing what's right from heaven's eyesight, from heaven. Come on now. We ain't got to worry about being distracted by doing a bunch of good things, but not the right things. And so people are not doing a bunch of good things, but you still can be doing the wrong thing at the expense of the right thing. And so Adam, I need to keep you focused and doing the right thing.
But how easy it is for somebody else to come in the garden and cause you to do a good thing and cause you to die and be separated.
That's why, man, you got to be on your P's and Q's. Because every voice that comes to influence is not for your good.
That's right.
Keep reading. What it say? And whatever he called them.
Whatsoever Adam called the creatures, there was a name thereof. And Adam gave name to all cattle, all fowl of the air, and all beasts of the field.
Uh-huh. All right, listen to that now.
And the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon Adam, and he slept. And he took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh instead thereof.
Hold on now. Now, God created every beast from the ground, of the field. All right. Now, when it came to Adam's helpmate, when it came from Adam's helpmate, so y'all got to catch this now. When you start understanding the kingdom, you gotta stop looking outside of yourself to think that everything you need is on the outside. And God says, all I need to do is put you in a deep sleep, so I can reach in you and pull out what you need. Because everything that we need is not on the exterior, it's on the interior. And you still searching for everything on the exterior. Because God placed eternity in our heart.
Yes.
He placed it on the inside. So if anything that we would need, all we have to do is go on the inside.
Yes.
Huh? Yes, sir.
Thank you.
back to church. And so here it is, don't catch it now. Anything that you take out of its normal use is called add. Put God from time. That's where you get that word abusive. Abusive.